Hi guys, welcome to this video. In this video we are going to create an headphone using Creo Parametric. So let's get started. So at first click on new and click the default template, enter the part name and select the unit as MMNS part solid, then click on OK. At first I am going to create a sketch, so go for the sketch, select the front plane. So it must be the reference of right plane, sketch, and go for the sketch view. So here I am going to draw an arc as a center at its ends like this. So now I am going to close it by drawing a line here. Then I am going to adjust this radius value as 25. So then I am going to draw a center line like this. So then I am going to click on OK. We are doing this for the revolve feature, so go for the revolve. So as you can see, our revolve part is got completed. So let's click on OK. So now the first feature is got completed, so let's go for the second feature. Go for the extrude, select the front plane and go for the sketch view. So here I am going to extrude a circle with a diameter of 6 and with the distance of 9, then click on OK. I am going to extrude this on both the sides to a value of 50, and click remove material. I need this to be an extruded part, then click on OK. So now the second feature is got completed. Let's go for the third feature. For that I am going to create a plane, so go for the plane, select the right plane, flip this inside and drag this towards inside. So I am going to enter this plane distance value to a value of 9 which intersects this axis, then click on OK. So now I am going to sketch this new plane, so go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. Here at first I am going to create no interline feature for this. So then I am going to create a rib here for dragging this part. So at first I am going to draw a corner rectangle like this, and then this distance must be a value of 55 and this height must be a value of 28, and this distance is a value of 55 divided by 2. And then now I am going to fillet these edges. As you can see, the sharp edges for this, all the four sides. Then let's go for the dimensions. I need this fillet radius as a value of 10 for both the tops, and for the bottom I am going to enter a value of 2 here, and here also the same 2, and then click on OK. So now as you can see, our sketch part is got completed. So I am going to create a sweep feature for this, so go for the shading with edges and go for the sweep, select this line, go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. So here I am going to draw a circle with a diameter of 2 here, and then click on OK. So as you can see, our sweep part is got completely done. So then click on OK. So now I am going to create another sweep feature for this as a bush. So go for the sweep, select this line first and go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. So here I am going to draw a circle with a diameter of 10 and then click on OK. Then click on OK. So now I am going to create this for the another opposite side. Click on this line, go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. Here also I am going to draw a circle with a diameter of 10, then click on OK. So now you can see our sweep part is got created. So now let's go for another sketch. Go for the sketch, select the front plane as a reference for light line plane. So go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. So here at first I am going to make this circle as a reference circle, then close it. So then I'm going to draw an arc as a center and ends, as a center here, as a reference for this edge, and I'm going to draw an arc like this, and then go for the dimensions, select this length to be a value of 55 and this radius is a value of 60. And now I am going to make this point and this point as a vertical constraint. Select this point and this point. So now our feature is got completed. Make sure that you align in this correct center reference. So then click on OK. So now for this line we are going to create a sweep feature. So go for the sweep, select this line, go for the sketch and go for the sketch. So here at first I'm going to draw a center line, then I'm going to draw a corner rectangle, or you can draw a center rectangle also like this, and the total height to be a value of 30 and this length to be a value of 2. So now I'm going to make these edges as a round feature. You can use fillet tool for this, or else you can use a 3 tangent circle. Select this line with this line and draw a circle like this tangent. As you can see, 3 sides are tangent. So now repeat this for this side. Select this line and select this line and draw a circle with 3 side tangent. So now let's delete the unwanted segments. Please make sure that you are deleting every single segment that affects our sketch. Same on the top side. So then let's go for the select option. As you can see, the pink color, our sketches got fully constrained. So now click on OK. So as you can see, our sweep part is got completely done. I successfully created without any constraints. Then click on OK. So now you can see here it doesn't joins good, so I'm going to make another joint feature for this. So go for the extrude, select front plane and go for the sketch view. So here at first I'm going to make reference for the circle. As we get the center point, I'm going to draw a center point circle with this to a value of 3. Click on OK, and I'm going to extrude this on the both the sides feature as a symmetric extrude, and I need this value as a 35, and then click on OK. So now you can see it is got fully constrained. So now I'm going to create some holes here. So for that, go for the extrude, select this face and go for the sketch. Here you can see this line doesn't create any reference for us, so go for the center line, draw a vertical center line, and now I'm going to draw a circle with a diameter of 0.50 and then click on OK. So now I'm going to flip this inside to an extrusion of 0.50. So now I'm going to edit this diameter as a value of 1, then click on OK, and the depth as 0.50, and this one remove material in feature, click on OK. So now I'm going to pattern this hole towards this entire surface. Go for the pattern, and I'm going to use fill type for this. Go for the fill, go for the reference, go for the define. Select this face as a defined sketch and go for the sketch view. So here, as you can see, the two reference, if you doesn't got any references, you can use this plane as a reference and this vertical plane as a reference. So now let's go for the sketch. I'm going to draw a circle with a diameter of 35. Then click on OK. As you can see, our feature is got filled successfully. So I'm going to add some facing feature for this. So I'm going to add 5 for facing, then click on OK. So now our whole feature is got completely done. So now I'm going to sketch another new plane for creating a holes here. So go for the sketch, select DTM1. Select DTM1 and go for the sketch and go for the sketch. Don't make any references for this plane. So now switch off all the datum planes. So now I'm going to draw a circle from here. I'm going to enter this dia value as 8 and this distance to be a value of 15, and then click on OK. Go for the extrude, drag it like this, and then click on OK. So now I'm going to repeat this by patterning it. Select this extrude, go for the pattern, go for the axis pattern, click on the axis display, close it. Now select this center axis. I need a number of 8 here with an angle of 360 divided by 8 as a angle of 45, then click on OK. So now our round feature is got regenerated successfully. So now I'm going to create some round features for this. So go for the round and enter a value of 1.50 as a dia. Select this surface for the all the surface. And then click on OK. So now our every features are created successfully. So now I'm going to create a mirror tool for this, for mirroring this whole part towards the right side. So click on plane display, or else you can hide this also. So now select the sketch, revolve, extrude, DTM sketch, and select the sweep 1 and don't select sweep 2 and sweep 3, and select sketch 3 and sweep 4, extrude, pattern and pattern of extrude, and go for the mirror. Select this face. As you can see, every parts are regenerated successfully. Then close it. So now we need to create some round features for this, because round features can be mirrored. So go for the round, enter the same dia, select intent chain, select this chain, then click on OK. So now we need to create some sweep feature for this. So go for the sweep, select this line, go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. So here, as we do for the first part, I'm going to create a circle with a diameter of 10 here, then click on OK, then close it. So go for the sweep again, select the opposite line, go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. Here also I'm going to draw a circle with a diameter of 10 here. So click on OK and click on OK. So now our every features are created successfully. Let's check whether our part is fully constrained or not. So now, as you can see, the sweep lines. So let's go for select this sketch, sketch 2, sketch 3, sketch 4, hide this all. So now select this line. As you can see here, select sketch 1, sketch 2, sketch 3, hide all this. So now our every parts are created successfully. So now let's give for some appearances. So go for the view, go for the appearances. So here I'm going to give some mix color for this as a fabricated color, as a black color for this entire part. Click on OK. Click on shading with reflections. So now I'm going to create some metallic color for this. So go for the appearances, select the metallic color and select the intent surface. select these surfaces. You need to do the same for the opposite sides. Sorry. You need to create inside also. So select these inner circles. Then repeat this for these inner circles. Then I'm going to add metallic color for this handbar also. As a metallic color, it gives some good look for our headphone. So now you can see here there are no holes seen. As we can see here, like clicking this. So now I'm going to create some color for this as a different color. So now go for the mask, and I'm going to give some composite color. As a composite black, select this surface with this surface and then click on OK. So now, as you can see, our part is got fully constrained. So now you can see here there are holes which is in black color. It's a good looking, and this metallic color gives some good reflections. So thanks for watching, guys. So if you want more videos related to mechanical engineering or any other content, you can comment below. And if you are new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe to get new videos. And don't forget to like this video, guys.